broken out, and he showed him, and Bruce said, "I love it." He's like, "I love it," and but I hear the chorus a little bit different, which pissed me off. No, I'm just kidding. I said, "Listen, Bruce." Now, but he rewrote the chorus, and Ron sent me a voice memo of him singing it, and I was floored. I was in Missouri at the time. My wife was in chiropractic school. She's a full-time chiropractor now, doing great. Yeah, she's killing it.
Sweet. And,
yeah. And so we were listening to this, and she's like, "How are you not blown away right now?" I was like, "I am. I just can't speak. Like, Bruce is singing my song." So it's just such a dream come true. It's called "Just You, Just Me," and here it goes.
Thank you.
face painted up, rocking all camo. Cut the gap between quitting and fishing time. Get a raise every time I put a deer down. Get a drink on the river when the sun's out. Even minimum wage would be just fine.
I'm stepping into something here. I don't know.
teach you to tell that story.
What'd you say?
You ought to keep that story in your pocket the next time we do one of these.
That brings up another thing. William Jennings and I were writing an album for him, and I was having some fun with him because he has a great sense of humor. That little line down on a piece of paper, roll it up, and put it in your pocket, and in a couple of days, you throw that so-and-so away. That was Waylon's humor. He was a wonderful man, actually. Miss him, miss him, miss him. Feel free to sing along if you want to.
It's a little too fast for me.
hesitate to play guitar behind him. You know, I like some of that hair, too. I like to play guitar.
Mark, you're up, buddy.
I do want to say something before we get started. I was this close to being a country music superstar. You mentioned Keith Stegall. He was supposed to be in that, didn't make it. Probably because he knew I was probably going to bring this up. He did produce me early on. And Alan Jackson wasn't very good looking, couldn't sing, not much of a writer. And he went with him. I don't get it. He could have had me.
This is a true story. Oh, years ago, when Kenny Chesney was just...
Don't tell my Kenny story. Chesney. Don't tell that. You're not leaving any dialogue.
Mark kind of indicated, he said, man, that guy ain't got much of a voice. And then Kenny started cutting his songs. He said, you know what? He's got where he sings better. That's really not.
It's amazing what a great song can do to an artist. May not see it the way they see it. May not do it the way they do it. But she lives her life for him. And he gladly died for her. And even in this modern age, it worked. Yeah, even in this modern age.
It's a song called Goodbye Time. It's your life. You say you need a change.
South got it, but the folks up north didn't. They thought shoot the moon at people. And down here it was Rook, right? So it died early in the charts. But I mentioned Wiener, Arkansas. When I was, we didn't grow up in a rice and soybean farm. We were a family farm. My mom drove the tractor, my dad, my brother, my sister, and myself. And we had one hired hand, and we'd bail him out of jail about once a month. During harvest, he was there, and that's kind of what we needed for. But my dad would take a nap at lunch. Mama would come in early and cook lunch. We ate three meals a day. And my dad was a pretty good sized boy. So I'd sit out on the front porch on this old box that really looked like a casket. I'm not sure, but it had a pad on it. And we had a screened-in porch because we had mosquitoes. So I'd sit on that thing until he got through with his nap, until we'd go back out and get on the tractors to dark. And I never forget thinking, I don't want to do this the rest of my life. We didn't have cabs on our tractors. It's dusty and hot, up and down the field. If you've ever row crop, it's just the boringest thing you do. So I decided not to do it. But like most times in life, we look back on our childhood and say, man, it was pretty cool. And so I've always longed. So Roger mentioned bulldogs. I've always had, since I got in the music business, I've always had a tractor and a bulldozer. It's where I could smell that diesel and dirt every now and then. And I think that's what kept me in.
Yeah.
Kept me going. But anyway, so Roger and I wrote this song together. I guess it was our second song we ever wrote. And Waylon Jennings had it, I think it died in the 30s or something. But then Travis Tritt made it a hit. And, my version is nothing like
it. I'll say it started off slow and tapered off.
Yeah, it did.
So when Mark wrote me this title, I said, man, I love this title.
Well, you know, it's kind of the songwriter's license. We raised rice and soybeans, but I could not fit that rhyme into this song, so we went with corn. As we sat on the front porch of that old gray house where I was born, stared out at the dusty fields, her dad has always worked hard every day.
Feeling guilty.
Yeah, check 1, 2. Have faith, don't live in a rush. If it don't come today, be patient till it does. That's what my dad would say. Son, the things that matter most are worth the sacrifice. Thanks, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. I'll tell you that in time, you gotta learn. I'm all shook up. Ooh. Hey, yeah. Well, my hands are shaking and my knees are weak. I can't seem to stand on my own 2 feet. Ooh, do you think when you have such luck, I'm in love? I'm all shook up. Ooh. My heart beats so it scares me to death when she touches my hand. I wanna chill like that.